Hello everybody, we continue with our games. Today I prepare one, for me it's a nice game, and I hope you will like also. It was a game against Grandmaster Milan Vukic, who is very famous in our country. He is old Grandmaster with a lot of chess experience, and I was so happy to play against him. And we will see how it was in this game. He was white and he started knight f3. I played knight f6, g3, d5, bishop g2, e6, castle, bishop e7, c4. And it's going in some kind of Catalan defense. I played castle, and now he should play d4 and then his Catalan defense, but he played b3. This is also some kind of Catalan, but in different setup. Knight bd7 and bishop to b2. I continue to develop also pieces to put bishop on this diagonal on b7. He took, I took d4, and then bishop b7. Knight c3, rook e8, and everything is famous. Both side wants to develop pieces. This is some normal. This opening is so quiet. Nothing happened in the opening. Just first we have to develop pieces and then to start to make some strategy. Here I played the move a6 because I wanted to put my bishop to d6 and my opponent cannot jump with knight to b5. Then queen c2, bishop d6 to make control of the square e5, that he cannot jump to e5. I have control with three pieces. This is important. Rook d1, he continued to develop. Knight f8, wants to go knight g6, e3, and I played rook c8. In some moment I want to play c5 and my rook is preparing there for this. And he move knight e2. This is a nice idea, e3 and knight e2. Maybe this knight can later to go to f4, but queen and rook on c file, they have some open file, and it's interesting. And bishop from b2 will be open. This is also important if black plays c5. But I didn't. I continue knight g6 to make control of this square e5, because maybe he wanted to jump to e5. Now he cannot. I control three times. And in this position, my opponent played very well. This position, I think my opponent played this position many times because he is a grandmaster with a lot of experience, and in his chess career, he played so many chess games, blitz games, rapid games. And I think he feel this position very good and he knows where he has to put the piece. Okay, in this position he played bishop to h3. Bishop h3, attack my rook, and now what to do? Where to go with rook? I have to move the rook. I move rook to b8, and now we can see excellent move for white is knight e5. I stop white to play knight e5, but he just played that knight e5, just pawn sacrifice. But now we can see that black, this knight e5 is good. Knight can jump to c6 and to make some pressure on this side. And also maybe in some moment f4 or many kind of possibly moves, but it's important black cannot capture, because after this take, take, Everything changed, and then on the end, Queen c7. And now we can see isolated pawn on d5, and white has big advantage because queen on c7 and open file for white rooks, and white is better here. And because of this, on knight e5, I should think what to do, because it's not so good to take. I played move c5. Okay, attack in the center, but my opponent hit it well. He changed one knight and then took to c5. And now there is some chance to take with bishop or with pawn. I wanted to take with pawn, but I have hanging pawns. Hanging pawns sometimes can be very strong, sometimes they can be weak. It depends of position. In this position, he played bishop g2 and attack to d5. Okay, black defend two times to d5, but white wants to take bishop f6 and then to capture to d5. And now I have to think what to do. I played knight e4 and close this bishop, and now it's protecting this pawn. And he played knight c3. He wants to change the knight and also attack d5. Then I don't have some other solution. I must take here, and bishop c3, and again we can see the pawn d5 is weak. How to protect this pawn? If I move the bishop, then he can also put queen d2 and then will lose this. I move the bishop because this is only move to protect, and then queen d3, and now I cannot save this pawn. White is better. He did so nice this opening and won the pawn. I didn't know I will lose the pawn, and I just push this pawn forward to make some change, and maybe I hope that I will have some chance. Without pawn, white is better, but to have some chance, maybe to try to save draw. Here my opponent, he took bishop b7. For example, also it's very good just to take the pawn, and if black takes with pawn, or just black change here, but when black takes, then queen d4, and we can see that white has clearly pawn more. This is some material advantage, but okay, there are some chance maybe for black if white doesn't play the best, and then black to try to save the game. Okay, on d4, my opponent, first he took bishop b7, rook b7, and then he took this pawn. Cd4, and now white to move. White can also play queen d4, like we said, and then is clearly a pawn more. But my opponent, he took queen a6, what is also not bad, it's okay. And rook is handing, and this pawn is also handing on d4. And how to continue with black? I played rook d7, protect this pawn, and I try to play d3 and rook e2 to make active my rook on second rank and to try to do something. And here white has some option. For example, queen a4 is a good move. I cannot capture this bishop because rook on d7 is handing. But then maybe black can play rook a2, rook e2, and then to try something, but it's not so nice. This is clearly better for white. or just to play d3 in this moment, it's d3. But another possibly move is bishop to d2, but of course black can play something like d3 and then rook e2 to try something, but white has pawn war. But I will show you my opponent in this moment. He saw that there is a pin and he moved his queen to d3. Because there is a pin and I cannot push this pawn forward to play d3. And if I take the bishop, he will take my rook. But it was combination. He overlooked. He made big blunder with queen d3. I took the bishop and he was surprised when he saw this. Then he saw combination, but when he moved this, he didn't see. He made mistake because everybody make mistakes, and this is something natural that you cannot always see everything in chess. Sometimes the best players in the world will also make some mistakes sometimes. Here he took the rook and he overlooked this move. This was nice move, rook e1 check, and it was this kind of combination. If king g2, then this is not good. If king g2 comes, then black can capture the queen, rook capture, and then rook c1, and in this moment black is much better. And of course he took here and I took the queen, and now black has queen against rook. There is a bishop. This pawn is so strong, pawn on c3, and will make a lot of trouble to white. Maybe white can play rook to e3, but then has to think about bishop b4 or something, what will happen. And my opponent immediately he gives here exchange, but he was sure that he will save the game, because there are so many end games, something like this, where is not so easy with queen to make progress. And here I will show you also some interesting moment when black cannot make progress, but in the way how I played, it was the best way, and then I won the game. For example, here, if white is waiting, how black can make progress? Just king g2, king g1, something like this, and I played g5. And now my opponent take. And here, because I know this kind of endgame, and then I know that I played queen d5, and to take with queen to g5. But I know that pawn takes to g5, this is only draw. I cannot win this endgame. And here is important that white can play g4 just to give this pawn sometimes. And then he has g3 square for his rook, and in some moment white rook can play only rook g3, rook e3. We can see this endgame. This endgame is draw. But engine doesn't say. Engine say that black is better, but black is better, but black cannot win. This is what is important. Black is better, but it's not winning for him. King f6, and then rook e3, queen g4, rook here, and queen to give for the rook, it's not so good. But how to cross with the king on this side? It's not easy to cross, and here there is a problem, because the pawn on b3. If there is no pawn on b3, then black can Give queen for the rook and then to win pawn endgame. But b3 pawn is very important for white. White cannot lose b3 pawn. And for example, how king cannot do anything. But maybe king can go this way. But what to do if king is there? For example, here. Okay, and for example, queen here, then rook here. But now, for example, some queen sacrifice, this is nothing. Because white is doing this and then just change everything. And then it's a draw. Then it means that after rook e3, queen has to go back and rook g3, king e2, and now make something here, but rook e3 again. And king has to go back and rook g3. And this position is draw. Just to play rook g3, rook e3. And to keep the pawn on b3, this is very important. And because of this, in this moment, I played first queen d5. And then took this pawn with queen. And then I have f and g pawn. F and g pawn, they are so important. And the white cannot make some kind of to build this barrier that don't give black king to go forward, because f pawn can take some squares later. He pushed this pawn, but if he doesn't push, then black will play f5, g5, and then on the end f4, and this rook will not have some squares. Okay, g4, queen here, rook g3, but now I continue with king. He moved king there. He cannot play b4 because we'll lose this pawn, and then he has to wait. And after some moves, here, king here, king g1, queen b4, king f1, queen d2, king g2, and queen d1. And now we can see this is a Zugzwang. White doesn't have any move. White need to play something, but what to play? There are not so many moves. He played move g5. But what to do? For example, if he moves king h2, then white can play queen f1, and then we can see again it's some kind of pressure. F2 pawn, how to protect, must play here, and then black is winning. It means that king h2 is not good, but what is with rook e3? But rook e3 then is losing this pawn. It's so easy. And after here, and black has two pawns on the king side, and this is winning. And white cannot capture this pawn because of check and take the rook. Then it means that rook e3 also is not good, but what to do else? Maybe b4, but b4 is just easy. Black is playing here and then will win the pawn. Okay, here can take also maybe to g4, king g4, rook f6 maybe, but okay, this is something like this, and then queen capture here, and this is much easy to win. And it means in this position white is in Zugzwang, and white played g5. And here we know from before that it's a big mistake for black just to capture with f-pawn. With f-pawn, black cannot capture because it will be draw. Something like this. I played f5, but pawn takes, and this is just drawish. Rook e3, rook g3. I played f5. And my opponent resigned the game because He will lose the pawn on g5, and then with these two pawns I will win the game. Then I will take some squares where this rook can make some maneuver, and it's much better for black. Yeah, it was a very nice game. It was interesting opening. He played excellent. He played very well in the opening, and some strategically it's excellent. But then one moment he just moved queen d3 and he overlooked the bishop because didn't see the tactic. And this kind of endgame is also interesting. Rook against queen, that you have to know that sometimes pawn and rook and king against queen and king, it can be drawn. Just you move rook e3, rook g3, and there are some more pawns also, maybe it can be draw, but need to be careful. Thanks and see you next time with my next video.